this one I made about just under 10 years ago. It's looking a little bit sorry for itself, and I want to try and change the way it's wired up. It's got a temperature sensor in it, which doesn't allow the fan to kick in until it gets to a certain temperature, but I want to change that, and it sucks air in through the bottom and then heats it and into the shed. I'm going to change it so that it recirculates air from inside the shed, so I'm going to block that off and put a pipe in, and that's the plan for today. Hello, welcome back. I'm going to start a green renewables playlist. Probably about 10 years ago we dove in both feet, bought a house, our previous house, where we had 10 kilowatt solar, ground source heat pump, solar thermal on the roof, and this place kind of the same. We've got 15 kilowatt solar, we've got a battery which is new, we've had that a few months, so we'll dive into that, what's actually like living well then. Ground source heat pump, energy diverter to divert excess into the hot water, car charger because we run a hybrid car, and solar furnaces, which is basically what this one's going to be about. I've got a couple of repairs, a couple of tweaks I want to do to our two existing ones that we use to heat this shed. The first thing I'm going to do is going to get this off the wall. I'll take this cover off. This is polycarbonate or something like that, twin wall. I'll get this off out of the way so it doesn't get damaged, and then get the frame off, and then we'll go through it.
No, it's not perfect, but I think that it's worth it, even when it's hurting.
All right, so that's the cover off. The basic guts of this is there's vents in this bottom bit that let cold air in, and then we've got like a heat sink. This is just mesh, there's some copper pipe in there, it's all painted black, and the idea is that the cool air comes through this. As it comes up, it absorbs the heat from these, and then solar panels powering a little computer fan which is directly behind there, and on this one we've got a temperature sensor. I'm going to remove this because I'm going to change the way this works. I'm going to cut a hole in there, put a pipe through the inside of the building, block off these vents, so then the air is recirculated, and this, the back's peeling. I built this as a temporary test, but it's nearly 10 years old now, and it's just starting to delaminate, so I'm going to replace that back piece as well. So this is in pieces now. I forgot what a patchwork quilt it was behind here, really. It was all literally scrap bits of wood. But these are the vents. We're gonna block these in, give it a bit of a coat of paint because it's looking a bit sorry for itself, and replace that with one piece. So I'll have to cut out the holes and remount the fan and the solar panel brackets, which is what they are, and give it a good old tidy up. So the back's off now. You can see the foam. It's about an inch thick. Yeah, it's a soggy mess. This is long overdue, this being done. So that's off, and then we'll start looking at the new piece for the back there. Here's a new piece, just clamped it into position just to make sure it all lines up. It's looking pretty good. I'm going to drill it, countersink it, screw it down, and then we'll spin it over and start cutting the holes for the existing pipe and figuring out what we're going to do with the new one. Right, back panel's on. I'm going to put some oil or paint or something over the tops of these screws, because the other ones that I took out of the old panel, where it was so wet and soggy, obviously started rusting. On a side note, this drill here I've had since 92, original battery, and it's still going. Unbelievable. But yeah, random tangent that is. Black & Decker, who knew? So it's spun over now. There's our new board. We've got to make this hole for the pipe to let the air through. This is the existing setup. So theoretically, I'm going to use this insulation as a template and then just drill it out like that. And then I've kept the old board that was on the back, because that's got all our fixings for these. So if I line this centre piece up with that hole, hopefully I should be able to make these holes all fit, and the hinges, make it easier to put back together. Well, that worked out quite well. Holes in, lovely. Luckily I kept this bit, because not only has it got the mounting positions for the solar panel, so I should be able to just drill through this board and then it should, fingers crossed, go in. But also the brackets that hold this thing up, it's got the screw holes for that. Save me drilling more holes in the wall on the outside when I put this back on. So keeping hold of that may pay dividends, but we'll see. That's the theory. Let's see what it's like in practice. So this is basically the brains of the outfit, as it were. This is just a switch just to turn it on and off if I need to. It's an old PC cooling fan, bit of flange, bit of pipe glued to it. That sits in that hole there. A 5-watt solar panel. And I just got some threaded bar to make upstands to keep it away from there. And this is the bit we're going to cut out today. This is a sensor. It's basically a temperature sensor. So when a panel gets up to, from memory, it's 20 degrees, that then switches on and it lets this warm up before the fan switches on. But I don't think I'm going to need that because I'm doing it differently. I've blocked off these holes, these vents, with a bit of timber. I'm going to make another hole in here to suck the air from inside that's already inside and make like a closed loop. But I'll get this in and then I'll find out if them solar panel holes actually line up. But I'll get this in first and we'll come back to that. Well, I haven't tried this yet, but I've put a dob of silicon to hold these washers up because just getting it into this position, they weren't behaving. But my theory is that's all worked out. It's not a one-handed job, this, but they are lining up. Just got to get them in. There you go. That one. I might have to spin this over and get it, but the holes are lining up. So there we go. We're in business. Just got to pop them through. Bolts are in. I could have made the holes a little bit bigger. Would have made it a little bit easier, but they lined up, so the theory works, which is good. It saved me a lot of measuring. I've had a bit of a rethink. I think I'm going to scrap that mesh and copper pipe that was in there in favour of a maze. So I'll put a bit of timber in there, leave a gap. A bit of timber up here, leave a gap. So it has to zigzag its way around. The air spends longer in it that way rather than getting sucked in there, goes straight up and straight back out again. It has to go either way, but I'll show you on the big one outside. See, this one, apart from being much bigger, uses like the maze, so the air comes in behind that panel there and has to go across like this all the way up. So theoretically it spends a lot longer in this panel, because instead of just coming in the hole there straight up and out and into the back into the building, it's got to cover every inch of it more or less, work its way up. So it spends a lot longer in there, takes a lot more, or absorbs a lot more heat. That's the theory, so we'll try it. Something like this. I've just got to rip these down now to the same depth as that.
Why is it so hard? Strongest in the room, no one ever asks how she doing. Cause everyone around her just assuming that she's always fine, but in the meantime she feels ruined. Nobody knows that she's falling down, falling down. But you don't wanna see that, cause you don't wanna pretend everything is okay. Am I just alive or am I really living? I know I like to hide cause I don't like admitting. The way I feel inside making me wanna give in. Don't know how to deal with this pain that I'm feeling. Mama, I want you to know, no, it's not perfect, but I think that it's worth it. Even when it's hurting and you feel uncertain, and you feel like life is a burden. And every time you try to make it better, nothing seemed to be working.
The story so far. These are the bits I ripped off of that to make them fit. I'm going to use them as spacers. And this is a bit of old metal roof. I'm going to screw these in there. Theory being it, paint them black, they get hot. It kind of doubles the contact area because air can flow underneath it as well as across the top of it. I might narrow these down a little bit. But But yeah, that's basically where we're heading. I'll screw them in and then we'll paint it all black. And I'll have to mount it to drill the hole through the wall that way to fit the pipe. But so far, I think that's a big improvement on how we were before. And it was fairly functional, don't get me wrong, but I think this is a better way. I like the maze. I say a bit more air time or box time for the air. Right, we're back on. Had a little bit of a mare with that template to line the screws up. Thought I was being clever, I'll raise the hinges up a little bit so it sits nearer, or further down from the edge, raise them down a bit rather, so it sits further away from the edge. But that affects where the hole it was already there for the pipe. So I had to bring them back to where they originally were anyway. So no major drama, but however, it's on. Next bit. But drill that hole through that wall. And we'll use that new hole in the bottom there as a starting jig template for that thing, stop it spinning off. And then we can stick the pipe in. Hole's done, pipe's in. A bit of foam around there just to act like a seal, stop any creepy crawlies making their homes in there. I'm going to paint this black now, help it absorb the heat a bit more. Yep, as soon as I finish painting, it's going to start raining. Well, it's starting spitting. Anyway, that's it painted. I'll put the cover on now, and then obviously there's no sun, it's the end of the day, but it's a good day. Got it all done and more than what I planned, so I'm happy with that. I'll revisit this, hopefully get some numbers out of it, what sort of heat output we're getting. If we look at this, it's 39, or the internal dimensions is about 39 inches high, or 100 centimetres. So if the air comes in straight at the bottom, it can only travel 100 centimetres, 39 inches, before it exits at the top. So using the maze, we then triple that. If we go for the average, so if I use the centre of the channel, we've got 16 inches or 40 centimetres going across left to right, five of those, and then it jumps up, or it goes up 20 centimetres or 8 inches, and then the last bit is about 25 centimetres, so 10 inches. So that gives us a total distance travelled now across the maze of 305 centimetres or 130 inches. So you can see the difference that makes. I've got these mounted practically vertical, and that's deliberate, and this one's even tucked in under this roof. And the reason being is, in the summer, if I had these angled out in the summer when the sun's higher, it'd be so hot in there, it'd be ridiculous, probably get over 40 degrees in there. But this is to help out in the winter when the sun's obviously lower, so a steeper angle's better. So I don't want it roasting in there, but this seems to work. It definitely has an impact. It helps keep it dry now. I was getting a lot of moisture problems. I don't seem to get that now, so must be doing something right. Thanks for making it to the end. Like and subscribe. I'll see you on the next one. Falling down.